Friday, and you know what that means. Southwest Florida Crime Stoppers needs your help finding a couple fugitives.
Yeah, we have Trish Rout from Southwest Florida Crime Stoppers. You may have already seen her in our newscast today, but now she is live here in studio telling us who we need to be on the lookout for this weekend, Trish.
Well, we're starting off our list this week with a guy who's only been out of prison for a few months, and already he's find himself back to his lifestyle of walking on the wrong side of the law. Nicholas Clark now finds himself back in disfavor with police with a brand new warrant for violating probation following his arrest for armed robbery and grand theft. Detectives say Clark went to a liquor store in North Cape Coral and robbed the clerk at knife point. After collecting all the cash from the till along with a few bottles of booze, Clark fled the area on foot. Police, however, were in immediate pursuit and managed to locate and arrest Clark in quick fashion. He spent 8 months in the Lee County Jail, followed by 2.5 years in prison for the crime, before he finally regained his freedom in August. Now, just a few short months later, Clark has proven that playing by the rules just isn't his cup of tea. To date, Clark has 7 previous arrests for grand theft, fraud, drugs, and DUI with property damage. He is 5'9", 140 pounds, and has several tattoos, including a skeleton, cross, and a gun on his left arm, and a bulldog with flowers on his right arm. Next up is a guy who staged a robbery at a vacant apartment, then walked away with thousands of dollars worth of the victim's electronic equipment. Detectives are on the hunt for Keyshawn Isaac after he failed to show up in court following an arrest for 2 counts of armed robbery. The victim said he was hired by Isaac to videotape a rap video that was being shot in Fort Myers. He even gave him a $50 deposit made through a Cash App. But as soon as the victim and a friend unloaded all the expensive equipment, Isaac pulled out a gun, held it to the man's head, and grabbed his cell phone, cash, and all the recording items. Fortunately, that Cash App, along with his fingerprints, linked Isaac back to the crime, which landed him behind bars for about a month back in June. He was released from jail pending his next court hearing, which he bailed on last week, triggering a new warrant for his arrest. Isaac, who is only 19, is already a familiar face to officers who had multiple run-ins with him as a young teen. And now it appears he's continuing that pattern as an adult. Isaac is 5'9", 140 pounds, and was last known to be staying in the Dunbar area. Also on the run this week is a former banker who decided to help himself to more than $10,000 stolen from the bank accounts of senior citizens. A warrant for the arrest of Vernell Shelton was issued after he violated terms of his probation following an arrest for making deposits with the intent to defraud. Shelton was working for a local bank when he felt that he was passed up for a raise and a few thousand bucks in commission that he thought should have been coming his way. That's when he started issuing money orders from the accounts of his older clientele and depositing them into his own personal bank account. In total, Shelton siphoned off more than $12,000 in cash from his unsuspecting victims. His actions landed him in jail and then probation, which he is now in violation of. Shelton has 3 previous bookings in Lee County that include battery. He is 5'9", 200 pounds, and upon his arrest, he will be held without bond. And last on our list this first Friday of December is a guy who set fire to flags at 3 Bonita Springs homes, all because he was upset with how the country was being run. Joe Tetlow has 3 felony warrants for his arrest after he didn't show up for a court hearing to address the multiple counts of first-degree arson. Deputies initially responded to a call of a suspicious person when a witness saw his neighbor's window smashed in and the flagpole burned down. Within minutes, they found Tetlow trespassing on the property and igniting a Florida Gators hat on the barbecue grill. Deputies also noticed that flags and banners were burned at several nearby residences, which came dangerously close to causing the entire homes to catch fire. When they questioned the 37-year-old about his actions, Tetlow said he was simply frustrated with the direction the country was headed in. That landed him in lockup for 4 months before being released pending his next court hearing. He had been showing up for those hearings until last month when the South Lee County man disappeared from the radar. Telto is 6'2", 180 pounds, with 3 previous bookings for Grand Theft Auto and loitering. And once deputies locate Telto this go-around, he will be held without bond. And as always, if you recognize any of the fugitives we've featured here today, you're asked to call the Crime Stoppers hotline. That number is 1-800-780-TIPS. All callers will remain anonymous and will be eligible for a cash reward of up to $3,000. Definitely a good way to help your community, put some cash in your pockets, get these guys off the streets.
Yeah, a lot of bad crimes there.
Absolutely.
Thanks, Trish.
Thanks, guys.
Well, Iron Dome.